In general, of course, technology has its hazards for especially for children, very young children, but especially the teen years. I was a high school teacher. I specialize with teenagers. I'm drawn to them. Now more than ever, there are so many pitfalls, so many ways that could pose danger, not only for their lives, but their very souls. As soon as you can, as early as you can, when it comes to technology, be sure that you keep it in perspective, not only just by limiting the time, but when it comes to a strong-willed child, you may have to do a little bartering. You know, you say, well, I'll tell you what, I know you're dying to have this. I know you want this time. You understand, I want to keep you safe, right? Yeah, I know. So how am I going to know that you're not on sites that I'm not going to approve of? Well, I promise, I give my word. But you understand, how will I actually know? How will you prove to me that you're not doing something that's endangering you or that's endangering somebody else? And then you might want to barter even for the screen time. A lot of parents do this. Hey, I'm happy to give you an hour of screen time. I'll trade it for 2 hours of chores, reading, going somewhere, you know, doing a little bit of bartering. Give me a little bit of control, a little bit of choice, and give me some reasoning. So you're going to say, okay, look, I know that you want to play this game and you'd like to play it all afternoon. I just don't think that's good for you. And I think you understand that. So how about we talk about what's 2 hours of it worth to you here? I mean, we start on sort of a bargaining. Now, if they're not going to bargain with you or if it doesn't come out to be a fair thing, you say, wow, nice try. I guess it's not going to work, so let's just not do screen time at all. Wait. That's not fair. Well, obviously we can't come to an agreement. Yeah, we can come to an agreement. Well, okay, you want to start over? Now, see, your questions as you're going, again, you're shifting a little control to me. And so I feel like I have a part. I feel like I have some ownership in this decision. And even the most extreme violations are going to be met with punishment and with consequences. And I like consequences better than punishment. Even the strongest extremes are going to obviously be met with consequences. Again, as a strong-willed child, if you drew the line and moved it, how can I respect you? Where's the next line? So I'm just going to keep stepping over lines. At some point, you're going to have to do what you don't want to do, and that is say, nope, this is the line. I'm really sorry. I'm sorry you chose to step over it. Well, I think you and I both know you stepped over it. So the consequences are here. We get another chance tomorrow. And again, we're going to push and push and push you. That's not fair. And just give me 30 minutes. Nice try. The line was drawn. You agreed to it. I'm going by what you said to. See you tomorrow when it comes to this. So again, your voice is important, but so is your enforcement. You have to be able, I have to know that the line's there for a reason and that there would be consequences if I cross it. Not, you better not cross that line or you're gonna have, that's not gonna work. Well, you understand that if you cross that line, here's what's gonna happen, right? And get my agreement. Yeah, okay, whatever. Well, I just want to make sure that you understand. Well, you can't make me not do it. That's right. I can't make you not do it. You can certainly choose to do it and accept the consequences, but that's how it's going to go. Well, okay. I mean, it isn't always perfect for the way it works, and it doesn't work every time. But believe me, you are going to be amazed at how often it really does work.